Hello, everybody. This is Ask Joshi, and we're doing another deck tech and discussion. This one is called Spells and Dongers. It is just Ezreal, Heimerdinger, and a ton of spells, topping out at Karina Veraza, which also has an incredibly powerful spell synergy. So let's go through the entire deck, kind of one card at a time. Mystic Shot, deal 2 to anything. Very self-explanatory, includes the enemy Nexus, don't forget. Scrap Dash Assembly, 2 mana to make 2 1/1s, but the fact is that it's a spell, so you can use actually banked spell mana to cast these guys. That's actually a great advantage of one of the other cards later as well. Vile Feast, again, self-explanatory, can use it to finish off fragile creatures from your opponent and get some blockers. Ezreal's in the deck, he's elusive and actually creates spells, Mystic Shots specifically, that do 2 damage. Static Shock is a great one. Deal 1 to 2 enemies and draw a card, so a little bit of cantrip there. Grasp of the Undying, drain 3 from an enemy unit, can help you if your Nexus is getting quite low. Also, of course, takes out a lot of different champions with only 3 toughness or health. Heimerdinger himself is the key card in this deck. Every time you cast a spell while Heimerdinger is out on the field, it puts a turret in your hand that's free. It's the same cost of the spell that you cast. So you're essentially doubling your card advantage whenever Heimerdinger is out in this deck. You want to protect him as much as you can. Withering Wail, another drain spell, helps you refill by mid-game. You're going to be normally taking a lot of damage in the beginning and the mid-game because you just don't have much defense, but the drain spells keep you in it long enough to get to these higher up abilities. Don't forget you can also bank 3 mana, so something like True Shot Barrage you could actually cast if you have 3 mana banked on turn 4. Unlicensed Innovation is a 5/5 illegal contraption, so again, this is a benefit just because you can bank 3 mana and cast it with 3 creature mana, or standard mana, however you want to talk about it. True Shot Barrage, of course, pretty self-explanatory as well. 3 to 1, 2 to 1, another, 1 to another. These also include Nexus as targets, so you could do 3 to the Nexus, 2 to a unit, and 1 to a unit. Vengeance, pretty self-explanatory, kill a unit. Karina Veraza, now this is an incredibly strong card in the late game. Not only is it a 7/7 body, you're discarding the top 5 cards of your deck, which you think, man, I don't want to discard 5 cards. My deck, you know, has all these good cards in it. But it can just do 5 damage to the entire enemy board, which is absolutely worth it. And in most cases, it's going to, because the only other creatures you actually have in the deck are Heimer and Ez. So it's deal 5 damage minus all Heimers and Ezes discarded this way, and other Karinas, I guess. Progress Day. So this is actually a burst spell, don't forget. I actually just realized that by playing the deck recently, that this is actually an incredibly fast deck that lets you draw 3. If you are all the way up to 11 mana, or even 13 mana, this can be a massive turn toward the end of the game. And there's only one copy of the Ruination, but it is the emergency button, kill all units if you are falling behind. So that basically shows you it's just a ton of removal, lots of spells, and spell value. So we're going to jump into a game. All right, this one's going to be FI, Freljord Ionia, one of the more popular deck combinations. And this time we're not going to get the Heimer, but we are going to get a strong start anyway with... Ooh, we did get the Heimer. Ooh, this is a very good starting hand, in my opinion. No expensive stuff that we got to wait around for. Progress Day is okay to have for later. We got the old Omen Hawk, staple of the Freljord deck. We're gonna play our Scrap Dash Assembly. Get some 1/1s out there just to take some time. And next we will play Ezreal. Ezreal's Mystic Shot does still cost 2 mana, so important to remember. So, Ezreal.
I thought you'd never ask!
And we can actually attack with everything, because net effect is he blocks or he doesn't. You know what I mean?
Shh.
Deal 1 there to an enemy. Actually, to Ez. Interesting.
Gotcha.
Would not have been my choice.
Stop bragging if you could back it up.
We're going to bank one mana again, which puts us at 5 on the next turn. Primer is unfortunately not a spell. We won't be able to cast him again for first until our turn. Could bank some mana potentially here during this round. Would be good to do. Maybe Mystic Shot is our one that we use and nothing else. Avalanche, deal 2 to everything. So that's why he pinged the Ezreal before. There's no point in playing any of our stuff. Actually very surprised that he did that. He got very little value for that. I think maybe he didn't want to do that. He's showing the emotes for I made a mistake. Ooh, Progress Day already. But Heimer already.
Answers, I have them.
I can also play Mystic Shot on whatever he casts next to create a turret.
Bring me the calm of an eye shrouded world.
You know what, actually? I'm tempted to attack, but we'll just Mystic Shot it and get a turret. Again, Heimer is a passive. We want to keep him on the bench and out of danger as much as possible, so we can keep spamming turrets every round. We got one banked still. That means we can cast a 7 cost, kill a unit. Actually, the turret could have attacked.
Send chills up my spine.
Turret maybe should have attacked. Whoops. Okay, Rhymefang is going to want to try to kill us, but we have True Shot Barrage. 3, 2, 1. Fantastic. And this also gives us a 7 cost turret in hand for 0 mana that we will play next. He is running Ionia, which is the deny color, but he did not have it available. So we just got a badass armored stomper, 7-1 barrier. Of course, barrier does go away at the end of the turn. Wow, what a deck. Yep, this is spell synergies. Seems quite powerful. I did lose to this deck once yesterday, and it inspired me to search up a list. I didn't brew it, did not brew it myself, but it is quite a good one. And now we have no unit to kill, or I would try to make another turret. Could kill a turret to make another 7-1 and potentially win the game. Kind of interesting there. I'm willing to do this here because he has no board currently, and it's possible we could save our guy. Brittle Steel, okay, that's a great move for him. So if he plays a creature that we can kill, then we'll get another turret. Excellent. So because I know we have another Vengeance in hand already, we're definitely doing this. And our 8 drop comes next turn and can potentially wipe his whole team anyway. So far, this is going quite well. I can see the power of this deck very quickly.
Unbreakable as thermodynamics!
Heimer, level up! Now, when you cast a spell, create a fleeting upgraded turret in hand. That's interesting. Not 100% sure what that means, but can only be good for us. Ash, okay. Let's just kill Ash and see what this upgraded turret's about. He's gonna deny, potentially? Yep, there it is. I wonder, do we get the turret still or not?
Shoot, shoot! That was years in the making!
I guess we don't get it. No, unfortunate. So if Ash attacks, it's certainly going to die to one of our 7-1s. Probably not opt to do that. You sure there? Okay, it does have a spell.
Avarosa, guide me!
Okay, Ash is gonna upgrade. I do still have the potential board wipe here with Karina.
dawn will be mine.
Now, does this also hit the Nexus or only
Behold,
enemy units? We're going to find out right
masterwork.
Now. He's crying. It does actually hit the Nexus, and we hit 4 out of 5. Crystal arrow does not bother us. You have potential for next turn.
Goggles on.
Lots of frostbite in that deck.
Fresh tracks.
Okay, obviously gonna hit, yep, the 0-1. And make a turret. Or do you even wanna make a turret? Sure. Oh, it's an upgraded turret, so he has +1/+1. Is he saying GG with the bow there? Not 100% sure.
There's a scent in the air.
Oh no, not my spider. Oh wow, it does count the Nexus for static. Good to know. GG. The Heimer deck. Quite strong, in fact. Another victory. That was a fun little game. Nice expressive opponent and everything. And we got another chest, which is absolutely useless right now because every card is already unlocked for the next hour and a half.